truckers. We got a full van for you tonight. It's me, Asia.
It's me, Derek.
It's me, Ian.
And it's not me, John.
John, it's you.
No, we have a John imposter in the building.
He's not real. No, it's no. Like Pontypool.
Get out of here. That's the intro.
It's a movie.
Or that's the premise of my first movie. John isn't actually real.
Speaking of movies, that's going to be the topic of today's podcast. We all came to the table today bringing in a sequel idea, like our dream sequel idea for all of you. So, who wants to go first?
I vote Ian, because he's at the end, physically.
It's me. I've got a real doozy for you. So it turns out that this is already made as a joke in BoJack Horseman, one of the greatest cartoons of all time. And my ultimate sequel is Paul Blart 3, Till Death Do Us Blart. I didn't actually have the title, but I'm just running with the joke. So, what I'm thinking is, and my favorite part of every Paul Blart movie is just the memes that result. So, what if you just take Paul Blart, put him in a completely serious drama, like canonically Paul Blart. Like maybe the beginning of the movie is the same as every other Paul Blart movie that are just like crazy and dumb and not really actually very good at all. But then you just put him in like a Titanic situation, and the entire movie, like there's no laughs. His weight isn't played up for laughs or anything. It's just Kevin Hart being taken completely seriously as an actor.
So this is not a comedy.
No, the joke is that absolutely Kevin not. Hart's being taken completely seriously as an actor. So,
wait, isn't it Kevin Smith?
No, Kevin.
Kevin Hart. Smith.
Yeah, Kevin.
No,
Hart.
Instead, oh, yeah, never Kevin mind. Hart replaces Kevin Smith, and no one says anything about it.
Paul Hart. Until death do us Hart.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. I think that's it.
So it would just be complete sadness, even with, like...
I would say, like, we'll just go with the Titanic, and it's the exact same plot, except they live at the end.
Okay, so say, so when Jack survivor. Is in the water, slowly floating away, he does not fart and bubbles come up.
No. it is completely, like, they both just hold on to the plank, and eventually, like, a ship comes, and they're saved. And, like, this is also the end, like, you figure out that this is the ending of, like, a trilogy, where, like, it plays all the scenes of, like, the past two movies, and then it just ends up with, like, a montage of his entire life, like, with his new love that he found in the Titanic, Rose.
Paul Blart takes up the space on the door that could have belonged to Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yeah, he's the one that gets an Oscar for a Titanic movie.
Oh.
Vote now on your phones. Yay or nay. So, Paul Blart, our Blarts will live on.
So, Derek, how are you going to follow that up?
Wait, really quick. Yeah. Instead of the song, the actual, like, song by Celine Dion, it's going to be, like,
it's the recorder solo on. Oh my god, plug. I played a game called Butterfly Soup, and they just legitimately used that song in some of the scenes, and it was so funny for me.
It was just really bad recorder solo of the song, and it's...
Oh god, it was so great.
I can just see, I can't remember his name, it's not Kevin, Kevin James, that's it.
Oh wow, I said Kevin Smith.
Yeah, Kevin Smith is a director. I can see Kevin James on the wooden door just playing the recorder.
And it's played as really cutely, because like his daughter's crying, his love of his life is
no,
like...
his daughter's not there, she was like, I'm not gonna get on this vacation. Strictly, only, pure, undiluted Paul Blart.
Wait, so he has a daughter?
Yeah.
I've never actually seen a Paul Blart
movie. Oh.
I literally just like it for the memes. It's probably my favorite, like, category of memes. Like,
I hate you. Get out! No, this is cut off. You haven't even seen the first two movies. When you were talking about a montage, you were just thinking about the memes.
So, exactly.
Derek, what's your movie?
Oh, it's, So, mine is also based off of a joke, but it's a joke that I want to be so real. Hitch 2, Son of a Hitch. It makes the most sense. Okay, first I'm going to set up the background as to why it should be made. Jaden Smith's career is kind of floundering. And honestly, he'd be...
excuse me.
Have you seen Neo Yokio?
Okay, despite Neo Yokio, despite the Get Down, he would be way more famous if he actually was if he just took a bunch of his old father movies and he just played his son in it. Men in Black 4, it's just Agent J again, but it's his son.
Agent Jaden. Oh my god.
Agent Junior.
Bad Boys becomes Bad Boys 3, and it's his son, and his son's like a rookie cop with Martin Lawrence and Will Smith. Like, we can keep going with this over and over again.
I'm not gonna lie, I wanna see those movies.
Will Smith cinematic universe, and it's just carried on by his son.
Oh,
and
shoot.
And then we bring Kevin James back again.
Yeah.
There was a movie with that. It was Big Mama's House 3. They did exactly
that. They could have just had his son play the rookie cop. I mean, they could have had his son play his son. It's okay, but...
But he wasn't in Big Mama's House 3. I'm saying they did that in Big Mama's House 3.
But Hitch 2, Son of a Hitch, Jaden's character would be called Trey. Like the actual forgotten Will Smith sibling.
Mm-hmm.
Like Will Smith's child.
I would be so upset.
The third one.
It's like, dude, don't take my name.
And Hitch, the character, he is very promiscuous. Like, you get that throughout the entire movie. So it's just like, even though he has the love of his life now, it wouldn't be that hard to be like, he has a kid he doesn't know about. And so Jaden comes back in his life, and Jaden's real mother in the movie is his actual mother in real life. Jada Pinkett Smith, because just get the entire Will Smith family in it.
Yeah. You might as well.
She's a good actress.
Yeah. And then, like, Willow can be in it, too. We can get a cameo from Willow. She can whip her hair back and forth. It would be great. And then it's just, like, he's going to get arrested. And then this is going to be in the trailer. He gets arrested. Jaden gets arrested. He's in jail. And then, like, he'll just be like, oh, who's gonna like, take care of you in court? And then the court door gets kicked down. It's Will Smith, and the court official's just like, ah, son of a hitch. And then it's just like, that's the tagline gonna come. Like, the song in the background's gonna go like, oh, 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 oh. And it's everyone's just gonna, like, have a great time.
I feel like I have to ask you this. Is this an Ian situation? Have you seen the first Hitch movie?
I have seen the first Hitch movie.
Oh my
because
I've seen the first Hitch movie, too.
Hitch isn't a lawyer.
Will Smith will channel the powers of everyone.
Oh my God.
Like,
it's a movie about him, like, being a date doctor, in quotes. Like, how does this follow the plot of the first Hitch?
So many years have passed.
But is not Kevin James a lawyer? I don't actually remember what he is.
Oh my God, he's in this movie too, isn't he?
That's what I was saying.
And he could be Paul Blart. This could be a direct sequel to your movie.
No.
Extended universe.
You both
with
are
Hitch
cut off.
Movie.
We are not redoing the Sandlerverse. This is ending. You are cut off.